So why don't I take you by F. Scott Fitzgerald's place since we're...
Oh, yeah? He lives in Minneapolis?
He doesn't live nowhere anymore, but he had a place in St. Paul.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Somebody's got an injury on their foot. One of the things that people often ask when they come to Minneapolis, especially if they're Americans, is, does Mary Tyler Moore still live in Minneapolis? Because there was the television show.
Is there like Happy Days kind of?
It was a very undynamic show. Story of a, woman after she had broken off her engagement and moved to a new town and starts a new life. And those apartments over there with the Mondrian paint job is where her character lived in the last season of the show. The MTM Productions that made that show would sneak into town and shoot footage of the house that she was supposed to be living in the first years of the show, and the people who owned the house got so sick of that they painted a big impeach Nixon sign on the outside of their home so that it wouldn't be filmed anymore. So then they moved Mary Tyler Moore over to these apartments. But it probably would have helped the show if they would have left it alone with the impeached Nixon on it. She never would have lived in these apartments. I mean, it's nothing but a 19-story crack house now. Maybe she would be living there. There's Fitzgerald's block of apartments right over there. I can turn around so you can get a bird's eye of it. There, you want that.
Can I missed it totally.
I can go around the block again.
Oh, sorry, yeah, missed it again. Oh, yeah, but
it's still dark, though.
Solid.
We'd have to go around about 200 times for it to get any lighter. There's a great coffee shop.
Okay, cool.
Right up. Hillary for president and Republicans for Voldenhorst. I mean, who did he buy that car from? Yeah, they're...
Mixed marriage.
Yeah, she rides on the left, he rides on the right.
You ever been to Nashville?
Yeah, peculiar town. Every bum with bus fare would come to Nashville with his idea of a song that is going to make everybody rich, or worse yet, more scary to them, an idea that somebody else, that he says he's got stolen from him. And see a lot of angry people getting off of buses in Nashville. And, country music has the image of being made, written, and performed by just ordinary, everyday people. And, ordinary, everyday people who put two rhyming words together, all of a sudden think that, you know, they qualify. It just so turns out that there's a lot more to it than just being ordinary and everyday. You know, they gotta know 50 people, and they have to, you know, go through the same process as anywhere else. The things you have to do in show business to succeed are not skills for a parent or a family person to have. You know, you learn how to betray people and take advantage of people and exploit people. And, you know, exploiters make horseshit parents.
Yeah, but do they make good performers?
They make good money, and that's all that counts in that world. Now, I would recommend the espresso. Anything that I think is hard to see a lot of today, that I think that would be the products of intuition and, yeah, dare I say, wisdom. I don't think we're living in a very wise age, which is needless, because there's a lot of wisdom. There's more wisdom at people's fingertips now than at any other time in history. You know, people have this great tool, you know, the computer and the internet, and, you know, all they want to look at is pornography. You know, that's important too, but Hart says pornography is important. For some more than others.
If you came across 12-year-old Grant, what would you tell him? Like, beware, or?
I would tell him, play with matches.
Play with matches?
Yeah, live dangerously.
Ah.
Take risks.
You feel you haven't done that enough in life?
No, if there's a 12-year-old Grant running around, I want to eliminate the competition. So if he kills himself in a fire, then that's good for the 40-year-old Grant. Eliminate the competition. No, a 12-year-old Grant, I would tell him not to take it as seriously as they might be inclined to. No matter what you prepare for, there's always going to be the thing that you don't prepare for that is going to come up and challenge you in what you're trying to do. Shall we bowl a lane?
Yeah.
One game.
Perfect.
All right.